Hello and welcome back to my channel. If you're first time here, my name is Jenny, and if you're back, I'm happy to see you again. Guys, today I'm coming to you with my powdery scents, all the powdery scents I have in my collection, my favorite ones. I will show you them all. We'll go through them one by one. Niche and designer. So if you're into that, stay tuned. And if you're not already part of our small perfume family here, maybe you consider subscribing to my channel. I would love to welcome you here. And otherwise, we start with my powdery scents. The first one I want to show you is from the house of Lalique, and it is Lalique Satin. Guys, Lalique Satin is an oriental woody, and for me, it's silk in a bottle. Okay, if silk or satin would have a scent, this is how I would imagine to smell. It's beautiful. It's an oriental woody. It has heliotrope, and I get the heliotrope here very well. Gardenia, jasmine, tonka bean, a lot of vanilla, guys, pink pepper, sandalwood, patchouli, and vetiver. Now, it's creamy. It's silky. It's very elegant. It's very powdery. It's your skin, but better. It's like, you know, satin sheets that you put on your skin. I don't know, satin blouse or a dress or something like this. This feeling it is giving me when I'm wearing it. Very cozy. Sweet, but not too sweet. Just the right amount of sweetness. Beautiful, beautiful, silky, powdery vanilla scent. It's beautiful, guys. Really, I love it. I adore it. And as I said, it's for me, silk in a bottle. The longevity goes around 4 to 6 hours, depending on how heavy I'm spraying. I'm a very heavy sprayer. I'm an oversprayer. And if I really spray very, very hard, I will come up to 6 hours, but not more. It has a nice yash in the beginning, but I love the smell. So I'm respraying. I don't mind. Satin from Lalique. The next one I want to show you is the mother for me of all powdery scents. It's Narciso Rodriguez Poudre. The Poudre, guys, is for me one of the best powdery designer fragrances that I know. It's woody floral musk. It has the Rodriguez musk. If you smell it once, you will recognize it in all his scents and in the Poudre as well. It has jasmine, rose, musk, coumarin, cedar, vetiver, and patchouli. Now, this one is creamy, powdery. It's really almost not sweet. It doesn't have much sweetness in it. It's very musky. It's very sexy to me. It's very feminine. Men are driving crazy with this scent. This is my experience. They love it. My husband, this is one of his favorite scents on me. He adores it. And I really think it's sexy in his own way. The longevity on this one, guys, is great. I'm coming up to 10 hours for designer fragrance. It has a perfect longevity. Very nice sillage. It's absolutely crowd pleasing. This one you can wear anytime, anywhere. You will always be appropriate. Everybody loves this scent. If you're into powdery scents, this one is a must try. Narciso Rodriguez Poudre. The next one is more a sweetie powdery scent, and it is Amanisi Fiori. Now, Amanisi Fiori is a Chypre floral, guys, and this one has blackcurrant, mandarin, neroli, rose, patchouli, oak moss, vanilla, and musk. This one is more on the sweet marshmallow side. It's for me like a, you know, kind of this color like the bottle is. Imagine a fluffy cloud of a marshmallow, but in the most elegant and a beautiful way that you can imagine. Okay, this vibe is giving me the scent. It's very playful, it's youthful. For me, it's a happy scent. I'm loving myself when I smell myself with this scent. And actually, it's not the biggest beast in longevity. I'm coming, let's say, 5 to 6 hours with it, and I'm spraying it very hard, guys, really. And I'm coming up to five to six hours, somewhere there. But I love smelling myself. And the sillage is quite okay. It's really good. I really adore it. But it's so creamy. It's floral, sweet, creamy. And it has this fluffy marshmallow vibe in it. It's not too sweet. It's not overpowering sweet, but it has this sweetness and it's giving him this innocence. I see pink clouds, this kind of very beautiful, very feminine. The DNA of Armani C is somewhere very much in the background. Actually, for me, it's a different scent, but I prefer actually the C Fiori. If you're into this kind of scent, try it. It's a must try. The next one I want to show you is a niche fragrance, and it's from the house of Mikalev, is Mon Parfum Pearl. Now, this one, guys, is a little bit more grown up. This perfume I would recommend, let's say, end of 20s and higher. I cannot see a very young woman. You can do anything, but I don't see it in the first place. This is more grown up. This is more mature. It's a powdery floral with blackberry, rose, mandarin orange, peony, rose, heliotrope, rice powder, musk, and vanilla. And you know, it's this powdery, creamy, slightly fruity, but only in the background, mostly powdery, creamy. It's not too sweet. You smell that this niche quality, guys. This is very beautiful. The rice powder is giving him this beautiful, elegant, very expensive smelling powderiness. Very appropriate for any occasion. I love it. It's really, for me, it's a masterpiece. I really adore it. I have the Mon Parfum, the normal one, and I love it. And I adore the pearl one. This is just the powdery sister. The Mon Parfum DNA, I have it inside. I'm getting it, but still, it's another scent. It's really, the powderiness makes it another scent. And it has a little bit this vibe, you know, your skin, but better, more beautiful. It even has something like fresh showered, but in a very powdery way. Okay, this is how I would describe it. The longevity on it is very good. 8 to 10 hours I'm getting with it. It has a beautiful sillage. I got lots of compliments on this one. Mon Parfum Pearl from the house of Mikalev. I really, really like it a lot. And the next one is also a niche fragrance, guys. And this is from the house of Diptyque Fleur de Peau. Now, this, guys, is for me probably the most strange and beautiful fragrance that I have in my collection. From the beginning, small disclaimer, this perfume is not for everybody and definitely in my eyes, guys, not a blind buy. Don't do it. You might really dislike it. Fleur de peau means the flower of the skin, and actually this perfume should give you the impression how a natural skin should smell. This is what it should do. And really, if you do smell it and you have it on your skin, you will understand the name is perfect for this scent. It's a floral powdery aldehyde smell, guys. And we have aldehydes, pink pepper, angelica, bergamot, iris, rose, musk, ambrette, ambergris, leather, amberwood, and sandalwood. Now, what do I smell? After all, this one is really a vintage smell. It smells very vintagey. It smells, you know, like when you're opening a vintage powder, you know, maybe a makeup powder, but it's really a vintage one. And this smell that comes from this powder, this is kind of what I get here. Plus, it has a very dry iris. You have to like that. That's why I'm saying it's not for everybody. It's, you know, what I get mostly actually sounds very funny, guys. If I would hear the description, I wouldn't want to buy it, but it's beautiful. Believe me, it's really beautiful. But when you sharpen a pencil, this smell that comes from this when you're sharpening it, this is what it smells like, really, in the opening. You smell this sharpening a pencil. Plus, this very dry iris is very powdery. And you know what it has? It has an intimate vibe to it. I don't know. It smells to me very intimate. When it dries down to a creamy, baby, powdery dream, okay? And it mixes up with your skin and it It's just beautiful. When it dries down, it's a masterpiece. I never experienced something like this with another fragrance. Really, you have the impression that it's your natural skin smell, but in gorgeous, okay? Imagine your skin in gorgeous, and not a perfume smell, but just a beautiful skin scent. This is what it is. And yeah, what can I tell you? When I ordered it blind, guys, this perfume actually won many awards. And I can just tell you, I understand why. It's a masterpiece, but you have to like it. My husband, for example, doesn't understand this fragrance. He doesn't get it, okay? He just told me, you have better ones. He didn't appreciate the whole beauty of this fragrance. And that's why I'm telling you, don't blind buy it. You might get disappointed. This is a perfume, it needs time on your skin. It needs to work, and you will see how beautiful it will sit on your skin, how it will start changing and becoming something wonderful. Guys, I love this scent. It's just, I'm not recommending you to buy this as blind. Don't do it. Just in case you're intrigued, like I was when I blind bought it, go and get it. I recommend you 100%, but be aware that you might dislike it if you maybe don't understand what it is. I think it's not for everybody. This is really my opinion, but it's beautiful. I love it. It has a wonderful sillage. It's around 8 hours, the longevity on my skin, but I'm restraining it. I like it. I love this pencil sharpening. You know what else it has in the opening? When you know aspirin, these tablets that you put in the water, and this sharp kind of smell that comes, this has this perfume just in the beginning. It's not long, but it does have. It reminds me of aspirin. So all in one, it's a masterpiece, guys. I'm telling you, I have a whole collection behind me standing there. And this one is, for me, the surprise of the year 2021, because it's quite new in my collection. I never experienced such a perfume. Fleur de Peau Eau de Parfum from the House of Ditique. The next one is a designer and a big love of mine. It's Guerlain L'Instant Magique. Now, guys, this is really this is not an oriental floral. This one is a floral woody. It's a floral woody scent with anise, bergamot, lemon, violet, mimosa, rose, freesia, carnation, iris, almond, vanilla, white musk, sandalwood, and cedar. Now, this one is a powdery dream, guys. It's soft. It's creamy, it's powdery, it's elegant, it's almost innocent, okay? This goes for any age, for any occasion. It's really, here I see a Chanel costume. I see a black dress even with high heels, whatever. It's beautiful. And what I really adore in this one, it has a monster longevity, guys. This is a real beast. I have it on, it's my scent of the day today, and I sprayed it 6 o'clock in the morning. We have it in the night right now in Germany, and it's still on. I can still smell myself. It's a great, great scent, guys. If you didn't try it yet, this is a must try. Beautiful elegance in a bottle. This is for me a fluffy powder cloud, just so feminine. It's sexy in its own way, and it's really the name magic. It's really magic for me. One of the best powdery scents from the designer brand that I know. If you didn't try, give it a try. It's gorgeous. L'Instant Magique from Guerlain. It's the Eau de Parfum. And the pre-last, I want to show you one of my favorite perfumes for life. Delina Exclusive from Parfum de Mali. Guys, now this is oriental, fruity, powdery, gorgeous, gorgeous, feminine scent with lychee, pear, bergamot, rose, oud, incense, lots of vanilla, amber, and woody notes. This is really, it's sexy, it's creamy, it's fruity, powdery. It's, for me, woman in a bottle, okay? This is really so feminine. This goes anywhere, anytime. I love and I adore this scent. It's intriguing, it's mysterious, it's sexy, it's everything. This is everything. I cannot hype it enough. One of my perfumes for life. The longevity is out of this world. A whole day I can smell myself, and everybody does around me, and everybody loves it. This is a crowd pleaser. Whoever comes here into my room and starts smelling the perfumes, the Delina Exclusive is always one of the favorites. This is what I can tell you. Everybody adores it. Delina Exclusive Parfum de Mali. And the last one is a designer, guys, and it is Busance from the House of Rocha. Now, Busance is an oriental floral, and it's pear, bergamot, neroli, heliotrope, freesia, rose, vanilla, woods, woody notes, and musk. Guys, it's beautiful. For me, it's beautiful. It's nothing groundbreaking, but it's very pretty. It's a very vanillary scent, powdery, woody in the background, and it's very sexy to me. Okay, it even has for me a slightly animalic note. Okay, I don't know why, but it has. But it's mysterious, it's very creamy, it's comforting, it's elegant, it's very feminine and just sexy to me. It has this animalic sexiness. It's gorgeous, it's really gorgeous. It's not too powdery, it's on the sweeter side, but it's not overpowering sweet. The vanilla is very present in this one, but if you didn't try it and you like vanilla powdery scents, must try, guys. A must try, really. Gorgeous bottle, and as gorgeous as the bottle is, as gorgeous is the scent. The longevity on me is 7 hours, approximately, something around this. It has a beautiful sillage, good projection. I don't have really no problems with it, and it's really a great, great, totally underrated fragrance, guys, because nobody talks about it. I don't see nobody. Actually, I don't know if there's any YouTuber talking about it except me. I really say it's a great perfume. I love it, and I recommend you to try it if you didn't yet. Guys, these were my powdery scents. I hope you had a little bit of fun, and maybe you write me in the comments which powdery scent is your favorite, niche or designer, whatever. I would love to read it, maybe one of those that I showed you today. Otherwise, I wish you a wonderful day and hope to see you soon in one of my next videos. Until then, bye bye.